Welcome to the Black Phillip Show with Patrice O'Neal. Women's power is in your fear of whatever they're going to do.
Black Phillip.
Fat-tongued mongoloid.
Love, doctor.
I told my girl she's the fourth most important thing in my life.
So sensitive.
It was me, my career,
family,
my mother, and then her.
Ooh, that silk.
She only thinks she knows shit because I tell her shit.
Keeping your pimp hands strong.
I think my girl in my life is worth five bitches now.
Fellas, I'm ready to get up and do my thing.
Go ahead, go ahead.
I want to get into it, man, you know.
Go ahead.
Like a sex machine, man.
Yeah.
Moving, doing it, you know.
Yeah.
Can I count it off?
Go ahead.
One, two, three, four. Get up.
Get on up.
Get up.
Get on up.
Stay on the scene.
Get on up.
Like a sex machine.
Get on up.
Get up.
Get on up.
Get on up, stay on the scene.
Get on up,
like a sex machine.
Yeah.
Get on up, get up,
get on up.
I like that.
Stay on the scene.
Yeah.
Get on up, I like a sex machine.
Get on up. I'm winding down. I'm not a machine no more.
Though.
I'm more like a fucking a sex.
Stay on the scene.
Like a sex, a old like a sex carburetor, nigga.
You got to have the feeling.
Yeah.
Sure you
bone. Don't be turning this shit down.
Get it together.
Yeah.
Right on, right on.
I want all you fucking white people with hangovers who had a drunk Irish fuck last night who woke up and said, oh, shit, this bitch is still here. When this bitch gonna leave? I thought last night when you motherfuckers thought your wife was some bitch you just met at the bar. Oh, my God. Well, well, well. Thank you very much for coming tonight to the Black Phillip Show with Patrice O'Neal and Dante Nero and the lovely Kathleen. Yes, yes, you assholes. Kathleen Roll is still here, and the bitch ain't going nowhere. How about that? Huh? 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 You lonely motherfuckers, don't judge her. She's working. Huh? Huh, you fucking assholes? Huh? You want to rape the hole? Do you realize? You motherfuckers wrote, I'm going to rape the hole.
Yeah. Monster Rain 856.
She remembers the...
This bitch, this is the thing you have to understand, is why she's here. What normal bitch, right? She went on to whackbag.com, right? And read, they had the Black Phillip, what do they call that shit?
The
message.
Whatever.
Thread. The thread. They had the Black Phillip thread. And I read one or two. I couldn't get past, you know, they're like, oh, the fucking, blah, blah. I'm like, man, my ego gets bruised with that shit. Because especially when it's people you don't know. The reason that she's here is because this crazy bitch read the entire 27 threads. And I guess each thread of the thread is 20 or 25 fucking little
posts,
comments
little
and
posts.
Posts or whatever the fuck. This bitch read all of them. So she calls me and goes, I read all of them. You know, it started off weird. It started off weird. Some guy said he wanted to rape me and throw me in a ditch. Not an average.
Well,
the average bitch would go, Patrice, I'm
creative,
not coming back. I'm
really?
Never coming back. I can't deal with this rapey shit. This motherfucker read it
every last
until
one.
The last one, and then at the end said, it got better.
Right. It's pie charts.
What it got? What it went from rape to I just want to hit the bitch in the head with a shovel?
The thing is, there's no way you could take this personally. One guy posts, like, every minute, not even every 2 minutes, and there's no way in hell that these people are... He's way too lazy to rape anyone. I'm telling you that.
Wait, how come you won't look at it the other way? Is that takes a lot of diligence.
To rape a bitch and kill her.
Some gamey smelling kid in his mother's basement. And I don't know.
Well,
you said they might be
now
older.
He's gonna rape you and sodomize you.
Yeah, no, there's no way. And they kept calling me a hole. This guy spelled hole,
well,
W-H-O-L-E.
Well, a hole is basically...
Hole, as in complete, not synonymous with gap.
He gave you the... definitions.
Oh, W-H-O-L-E.
Yeah. Yeah.
He called you the whole
in
thing.
Every post he did, which was every single minute, he used the word whole, describing me.
W-H-O-L-E.
Yeah.
I thought it was H-O-L-E.
It is H-O-L-E.
But he took the time to add a W,
and you think this guy's lazy?
No, I just think that this guy doesn't know how to spell whole.
I wonder if he knows how to spell rape. You think he spells it with an X, you fucking bitch? You better stop playing with these crazy motherfuckers.
This is some pasty kid, and he kept, he'd quote Jim Norton. He wouldn't even be derivative of, just regurgitated what Jim Norton had said, like some Jim Norton line.
Right.
And this is some kid that never leaves his house. I mean, there's no way. And also, he said things like, hey, where's the, you know, is somebody answering the phone? Like, he actually thought he was part of the show.
Really?
I mean, he's on this computer and,
case study,
I don't know.
Kathleen Rowe.
Yeah. So my favorite, though, was the there
oh, there
were
was,
women.
Wait a minute. There was more. Hold on. So there was more beyond, like, you got past the I'm going to rape
okay,
you.
Okay, yeah, the dangerous thing about this guy is...
Oh, by the way, hold on. In case you didn't listen to the show last week, this is the Black Phillip Show with Patrice O'Neill, Kathleen Rowe, and Dante Nero. And Kathleen is our version of a hole. And if you don't know what a hole is, hold on a minute. If you don't know what a hole is, it's not what she's saying. Like, she took it in some psychotic way that it meant... That she's a complete human being. Or
no,
she's a
whole.
Wait a minute. Shut up for a second. So she took that in that context. But a whole on this show, when you get to the situation, it's just a girl, and any girl is almost poison. So we have to understand the reason that you have a girl here is just to get a secondary viewpoint. You know what I mean? We can't be jerking semen all over the desk while we're cursing out bitches. You know, the reason that Kathleen is so great, and you will get to know why, is because she's insane. But she's genius. So only an insane bitch could absolutely read at least 150 postings of rape and torture and get through it and find something at the end that goes, it got progressively better. Do you understand that the average regular human being, I'm a pimp, and I can't go past the first fuck you fat boy shit because I want to kill a motherfucker. So that's why it's like, you got to understand what the use is there, is that we need somebody that's able to do that. Like, can you imagine if you had to read and sit there? Like she said earlier, that somebody called Dante
a spick.
Who's the big spick?
Yeah. Who's the big spick? And I thought you were black. Yes.
Right, and I am black, but I would still snap somebody's neck for calling me a spick.
Who's the spick?
Who's the big spick?
Who's that spick?
You big fucking
spick. You big spick. I'm not even, I'm black.
Patrice,
and
my
I was
point
still offended. Fucking jerk offs. Whatever.
Oh, they still, see, but do you see how it is? Because that's man shit. It's like right. Somebody goes, you know, some faceless, like she's going, you know, this is some little fat boy who's at the house. She gave him a profile. And you know, you actually feel for him after she gives him that pro. She actually made.
No.
She humanized a rapist.
Little boy.
A case study.
It's a pasty little boy, but you almost picture him in your head, just typing and being so attached. And then it's like me, I want to take him by his stupid little neck, what I'm picturing, and kill the motherfucker. Dante would do worse to him. And then Kathleen goes, you know, it's just a little boy who. He has feelings like everybody.
No, I feel no pity for this kid. And my point about the word whole, if you're beyond 10 and you spell whole as in cavity, gash, W-H-O-L-E, this is a really
But isn't that
stupid,
a more difficult way to spell whole than just use the H?
He was misspelling it is my point. And that's not a complicated word to spell.
Who gives a shit? You gonna get raped, bitch. It ain't my fucking fault.
I want to talk about the girl, though. Cunt face. This is...
Hold on!
Okay.
Bitch.
Cunt hair. Excuse me.
So some girl named Cunt Hair got
cunt
under your skin.
Cunt face or... some Uncle Tom...
Wait a minute.
They get the
wait
number.
Wait a second. Let me give out this number real quick. Now, I'm gonna try to get to a lot more calls this week. I cannot promise you I will. because I like to hear myself talk. I really do like to hear my voice in my own ears. So I'm going to give you this message, this number out. I'm going to try to rifle through some calls soon. But as of now, I really am interested in how bad they fucking trashed this bitch on Whackbag, and she read them all.
Oh,
enough
man.
To even write down who they are, cunt face.
I didn't write down
double
anything.
Slap. You didn't write
no.
anything. You just remembered.
No.
See,
no.
this bitch is Rain Man. Throw some matches on the ground. I bet you'll count them just by looking at them. All right, listen. Call the number is 866-WOW1-WOW. That's 866, and this is talking to the little boy that spelled whole wrong.
With a W.
866, because now motherfuckers will be like, W-O-W. It's 969-1969. So it's 969-1969, 866-969-1969. It is the Black Phillip Show. We'll help you out with your hoes, and we'll help you hoes out with yourselves and whatever. But we want to finish this whole cunt thing.
Oh, the cunt thing.
This, so there was a girl. Wait a minute. There was a girl on. So the shallow grave rape thing didn't bother you.
It was more like various anal atrocities or whatever. They're, you know, no.
He was political.
I mean,
he was going to holocaust that asshole.
Oh, she needs to be fired. Yeah, whatever.
Who
whatever.
Says that?
No.
Who
I
says
mean,
anal atrocities?
Now, let's be fair
no,
to the listeners.
I'm paraphrasing.
Let's be fair anal, to the listeners, yeah. Kathleen. Let's be very fair.
Okay.
Your voice is fucking atrociously hard on the spinal column and around the neck area. If you don't know you,
well,
your voice is so annoying that you got to understand it got to be fed into people. People got to feed you the voice. You understand what I'm saying?
That's okay.
You do understand that now. So you got to understand that some little boy, oh, they went and got this shit? Okay,
oh,
here we
no.
go. Here we go. Wait a minute. Wait a minute.
No.
Okay, wait. Let me read some of the, let me read some of the shit. Let me read some of the shit that they said to this bitch. Oh, my God. So, 480 Ruger. This motherfucker. Did they pull this hole off the street in front of the building? Ramon, feed this bitch a bucket full of AIDS. What? Why? Because her voice is annoying, you fucking asshole.
Well, the annoying voice thing came from a girl, and that's there. I don't know. I want to talk about.
You guys, this thing with this, with she really, you are on this. You're not gonna be able to focus. Wait a minute. You're not gonna be able to focus until cuntface 10872. What are you? Calm. Don't lose the focus. Listen. Okay, we had to get this whole this cunt thing out because she's not gonna be able to focus on the rest of the show if we don't talk about it. So this cunt, and I'm not saying
no,
this.
I'm not
calling her a cunt.
She's a cunt.
It actually that's her space
cunt
name
face.
Is cunt face. Okay, but you're paraphrasing cunt
exactly.
face or cunt hair. We don't want to get sued by saying the wrong cunt.
Right.
Cunt face, cunt hair, or cuntalicious. It's something like that. Okay. Now what does she say to you?
Well, it wasn't personal. Even before,
we don't care what it was. What did she say to you, Kathleen?
Before the show started, she said holes are useless. Is there a hole there?
This is
whatever.
Oh, this is another woman.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah, this
okay.
is a woman, and she has, I'm a girl. This is
now, how you know it was a woman, though? Because a lot of times you might.
Trust me, Patrice. This is a porky drunk chick.
Wait a minute. Listen, though.
And she's white.
Wait a minute. Wait a second. Let me
she's
ask
fat you. And she's white.
Okay.
I'll tell you, I know this.
Okay. This is what, it's the beautiful thing about it, but it's also the fucking annoying thing about it. The bitch has 14 different personalities, and she has to, there's nothing there. It's like if you tell one personality to shut up, there's a third that'll keep fucking talking. Hold on a second, bitch. Listen. So a lot of people call each other Sweetie Puss and Butterscotch and Honey Dribblets, like in
right.
our little crew.
Right.
Now, a lot of times they'll have space names, like there are names like that where it'll be a guy named Honey Nips or Butter Draws or something.
Yeah.
And it could be a guy named Cunt Face.
No, she specifically says she's a girl.
Okay,
and
fair
then
enough.
At the sad thing about her is towards the end, she's an Uncle Tom. For
hold
one.
On, wait a minute. Go to, what number is it? 9. Go to Reno in Mississippi. Reno, you said...
Yo!
Reno, what's up, man? You said she thought you thought she did a good job?
Yeah, I mean, she was a little bit nervous last week, but I thought she did pretty decent. I'm a big ONA fan. Also, Patrice, you're an awesome man. I watch Web Junk 20, but you and Dante and Cat was doing a real good job.
Oh, he fucking got you a little pet name named Cat, bitch.
Daddy.
Well, we call her bitch here, but you can call it you can call it Cat. But look and see, they don't all. Now, are you sure, Reno?
I was pretty good for a spec, too.
Hey, Reno, are you somewhere hiding under a bush or under some type of railroad track somewhere so nobody else could hear you say that you thought she did a good job?
No. Just driving home from work, man.
Well, see, there you go. Thank you, Reno. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Reno.
All right, see? Not everybody wants to rape and kill you, bitch.
No, I don't think they do. In fact, these posts, they were like five different people constantly posting. But the girl, towards the end, she's trying to be seductive on a message board. She's talking about how when her and her man, when she has an orgasm, she, you know, she's trying to be seductive. She's trying to sound like a guy.
Mm.
I say whole. I call myself cunt. Women are useless. And then at the end, she's trying to seduce.
What did she say that was wrong?
She's going to go through
you
that.
You left me speechless.
What'd she say that wasn't
hard
right?
Drive, she pulls her brain and pluck it right out.
Oh, we're going to take a quick call. Hey, Eric in New Jersey.
Yeah.
What's up, man?
What's going on? How you doing?
Nothing, pumpkin.
All right, dude, here's the thing. Here's all the shit in a nutshell. I fell for the classic fucking bait and switch shit. You know what I mean?
Right.
Like, I've been with my woman for 15 years. When we first started dating and all that shit, it was fucking, dude, the sex is fucking phenomenal. Like,
of course.
Yeah, let's freaky shit. Let's watch porn, fucking do it all. And now, 15 years later, like, it's like once a year, one more thing just gets taken away. I don't like that. I don't want to do that. And you know, I never liked that, she's telling me. So now I'm like having fucking purity sex.
You're too accessible to her. That's what, see, what the problem is. When you hunt, right? For men, what's our hunt? What are we hunting? We are hunting pussy. Absolutely. So when you get it, she has to kind of keep doing something to keep you kind of chasing her. Like, you can't. Once she gives you the pussy, if you feel like you can get it anytime you want and any way you want, you lose a little bit of that luster to chase her. It's like we have to go hunt something. That's why we cheat, and that's why our cheating is not personal. Our cheating is just hunting. Now, what do you think?
Absolutely,
do you think their hunt is? Because they're hunting for something too. What do you think that is?
Who the fuck knows, dude? Because you know what? It changes every guy.
Well,
they're hunting your manhood.
Whatever she hunted, Eric, she got from you. She got you. She got what they call a comfort zone. She got her self-esteem is high, and she got security. A good relationship, I'm telling you, is when a woman is just a little bit insecure. And I don't mean you tell a bitch her breath stink or she's fat. You just make her think that at any moment you could leave. Like, she's not completely, she doesn't have you. You understand what I'm saying? You gotta make her not want to have you, but you can't do it and tap into her anger. You can't make her go fuck you. You can't make her go ah. You have to just go, hey baby, you know I'm just gonna go on out. Give her a kiss when you go out, and show something else some love. Do you understand what I'm saying? Now, now Dante is married. Now I talked to this motherfucker, and Dante claimed. I asked him this. Do you think it will ever end? Like, I think, because I'm not married to my woman, that I gotta keep pimping the bitch. I gotta keep, like, constantly keeping my shit going so that this bitch is kind of confused. But I asked, does it end when you get married? Now, do you think it ends when you get married?
I think you have to keep, you say you have to pimp your girl.
You have to pimp your wife?
If you're married, you have to pimp harder. Because she's around you 24/7. She knows all your tricks. And after a while, the little tricks that you would normally keep her interested,
right,
it don't work. So you gotta be consistently inconsistent.
Ah, different.
At all times.
So you wake up, she knows what your favorite breakfast is, right? She knows what you're going to eat for dinner. She knows what you're thinking. She knows. here's what you do. When she thinks she's going to assume what you like she cook you some eggs, you throw the shit on the ground. Bitch, bitch, yo, how the fuck you know what I want to eat? I want oatmeal.
Yeah, but here's the thing. What he said, what he just said about that, you know, keep it consistent, inconsistent. Now, here's the fucked up thing. She's whittled down this fucking sex until it's fucking completely uniform and it's fucking her way. I'm like, all right, you know, you get in, and I know.
Well, let me ask you this: Are you
as a fucking guy, if a chick does something to you physically that you like tonight, you're gonna like that forever. If
she pimping you, nigga.
Yeah.
Son, Eric, listen, sweetie, hold on a minute. Let me tell you something. You gotta. Your ego has been bruised. I'm gonna tell you what she did. She got you. You're behind an eight ball right now. And the only way to get from behind the eight ball, right, and the only way to not be in a situation where you are caught in some kind of fucked up game is to not play. Do you understand
that's
that?
Right.
Learn that for right. War games. Do not play. She got you. This is where your anger's coming from. Listen to me, man. Your anger's coming from the fact that she got your balls. Do you understand? So you can't – don't be mad. Don't be gangster now. Don't be like, fuck that. She got your balls. She done made you go, when y'all fucked. She did something. She probably licked your asshole. She probably lick your taint, suck your help. She makes you come anytime she wants. The feeling that, have you ever fucked a bitch and then afterwards you looked at her and go,
she's trembling.
I got that bitch. That's what she did to you. And so you got to step back and this is what you got to do, man. You got to embrace. If you don't want to cheat on her, and I'm not going to condone going out to cheat, but you might have to do that. But what you do is you learn how to love jerking your dick. You learn how to just like to come. You're addicted, and you can't, you know, if you're on heroin, right, you can't just say, you know what, I don't want to be on heroin anymore.
Yeah.
You have to, the first thing they say about addiction is you have to admit that you're addicted. You're addicted to this bitch. She got you addicted to something that you think you can't live without. But I'm going to tell you, nigga, if you start squirting off about 5, 6, or 7 of them each week, how old are you, by the way?
Well, I'm 10 steps ahead of you. I'm 35.
You're 35, dude.
I'm a professional fucking masturbator. And the worst part is half the time she fucking rolls over. I'm like, nah, not tonight. I'm like, all right. I fucking whip it out. I take it right there. Fucking right. I'm like, you know, and then I look
right
over like,
you
but you got to stop. You got to stop saying not tonight, Eric. See, that's the thing. You're playing games. You're trying to force her to, like, be into you, dude. You got to step back and embrace the fact that you're jerking off unless you go, you know, wink, wink, get some side pussy. And I know jerking off is not the same feeling as some warm pussy, but you might have to beat your dick to the point where she gets, like, and another thing, too, while my mind is moving, you sure she's not fucking somebody else?
Maybe.
Yeah, that's the
no,
thing.
No, definitely not. I know that for a fact. I don't want to be so stupid to say I know that for a fact, but no, it's very unlikely.
How do you know, though? Was she horny when she met you?
Yeah, she wasn't like...
Why ain't she horny now, dude?
See,
what's wrong with her now? Is she sick? Did a pussy fall off? What happened?
That's some fucking... She's all into it. You know, it's back to where it was again, but the problem is that it's just getting her
it's
into
manipulative
it.
When it's not happening.
She's controlling you,
she's
dude.
She's getting out of that.
Take her power, take that pussy power away. What, Kathleen?
I think if, why can't they just both have sex with other people? It's over. Like, she doesn't want to have sex.
It's not over. I'm going to tell you.
With him.
It's
yeah.
him. No, no, no. It's him not. It's not over. It's him not pimping his
thank
marriage.
Thank you very much.
You got, if you're playing
hold on,
chess.
Hold on, Dante. What, Eric?
No, I was going to say, the rest of the relationship is great. No issues. We got kids. We got the whole thing. And, you know, kids are a bitch, too, with sex. But the rest of the relationship is freaking great. You know, we get along. We're good friends. All that bullshit. All that emotional shit that women want.
Wait, so you're good. Wait, you're good friends. You're good friends until you do that, the hard poke in the small of her back.
He loves her.
Well, then you're not
yeah,
happy.
Yeah, she loves me. She loves me undoubtedly, unquestionably.
Let me tell you what you're sounding like. Let me tell you what you just said. Everything you said that was good about the relationship is what bitches think are good about a relationship. We got the kids. We got the fam. That's the shit she told you? Nigga, you being pimped. Do you understand? Don't get mad.
That's what I'm telling you. That's what I'm saying to you is that the shit she would say is good, it is good. It's there. That's what they want. That's what women want. Emotional connection. That shit's there.
Then you have to take that away from her. If that's what she wants,
ta-da.
Then you have to take away from her what she wants until she gives you what you want.
What's she addicted to, Eric?
I have no idea.
You don't know what she likes. You got some motherfucking work. You don't know what she's addicted to? What is she addicted to? What can't she live without?
I don't know. Career and kids.
Eric,
oh, she's a career woman.
Do you know if she masturbates?
No, she does not.
Oh,
she'll do that with me, but she won't do it on her own. And I tell
she's
her
getting off on the power.
Up.
Yeah, dude.
She's getting off on,
all right,
on
Eric,
the power.
We gotta go, but I'm gonna leave you with this, man. I'm telling you, what you gotta figure out and walk around with what she's addicted to or what her comfort zone is. Are you a stay at home dad?
No. We both work.
You both were okay. Listen, man, you got to figure out this. You got to figure out
what she
really into.
Yeah.
And
take it away.
And don't fuck with it. You hear me?
Yeah, I got you.
All right, bye.
I got you. I'll give it a shot. I'll check back with you. It was great talking to you guys, man.
All right, Rocco in California.
Hey, Rocco.
Hey, Patrice.
Rocco.
What's up?
Nothing, nigga. What?
That's the question.
Fuck you.
I didn't hear nobody up there. Oh, shit. Hey, guys. Hey, what the fuck with this dude, Eric? Tell him his old lady to a goddamn motel and bang the shit out of her ass. That's all
good
it is.
One.
She don't want to
good
get
one, Rocco.
I like Rocco.
If she don't want to give it up, put a porno in and come on her fucking face.
Oh,
I like this guy.
Now, there might be some people out there that's going, oh, this motherfucker's out of his mind. But he's not out of
that's
his
what
mind.
She wants.
The approach may be a little bit wrong. But the technique is basically, let me tell you a quick story. Hold on, Rocco. Let me tell you a quick story about what I learned about 4 years ago. Something I learned. I might have told the story before, but I was fucking this girl, and she's one of these high. She was a high class person, you know, super lawyer, $500,000 a year job. So she was a very elevated type of
socially
progressive bitch,
elevated.
You know. But we were fucking one day, and I was coming. I'm like, oh, give me a come. Oh shit. I'm like, sit on my face. So she sat on my face, right? And I jerked off. It was one of the best cums I ever had. So afterwards, she's real analytical. She's like, wow, I never did that before. I go, well, why'd you do it now? And you know what she said? She said, because you left me no room for protest. Do you understand what I'm saying?
That's it.
It's not a rape thing. It's a... There was no space in her mind to be able to do what... There was nowhere for her to go, I'm not in the mood, or whatever that she was saying to Eric is, nah, not tonight, bitch. What? Like, my girl can't think about saying not tonight on any level, and it ain't because she's brutalized and no shit like that. It's just that there's no space between, like, her opinion and what the fuck I want. Her opinion is, like, the third thing on the list before, like, you sitting on my fucking face.
That's right.
So, Rocco...
Now, Patrice.
What?
Patrice, I've seen you on your web junk. You's one ugly motherfucker, but tell you what, I guarantee you...
Thank you, Rocco.
That woman right there loves you to death and will fuck your brains out just for the fact that you took control, you made it happen, and you treated her like she wanted to be treated. Not some pansy-ass bullshit, I'm not in the mood. Bullshit! You're going to give up the pussy, and you're going to enjoy it.
I know you don't want to like Rocco out there,
but you got him.
If you take a little bit of Rocco... And just put a little sugar in it. Rocco's like vodka straight, nigga. Now you take the hole and you shove a head in the toilet.
Rocco, think about it. Ask the bitch if she'd ever had a man just take her and just say, hey, baby, look here. You're going to lay down and I'm going to eat that snatch till you come. And shut up. No, I don't want to hear a fucking word. Drop them panties.
Yeah, but you know what, though, Rocco? Hold on a second. Now, do you know there are techniques to introducing certain things to a woman, like, you know...
Well, there's times for finesse, and sometimes a woman just wants you to go straight, raw, monkey sex on her.
Eric's
wife needs.
Eric's wife needs some monkey sex.
Wait a minute, though. Raw before I hang up, sex. Rocco, show me a little finesse
what?
Side. Before I hang up on you, show me the finesse side. What's the finesse? Anything that you say finesse a bitch with?
If I was to finesse a girl?
Yeah, got it.
I ain't got no
fish. If it ain't broke, don't fix it.
All right, bye, Rocco. That's fucking Rocco the Rapist. That nigga punch a
Rocco
bitch.
Rocco the Rapist, yeah.
Flush a bitch's head down the toilet. You just take it, fucking pee on the back of her neck.
And she'll like it. She would like it.
Oh, my God.
I don't think there's any woman that doesn't want a strong man.
Ooh.
Bullshit.
Rusty Knife. And I don't know where he's at, but Rusty Knife. Go ahead, Rusty Knife.
Hey, what's up, boys?
Hey, Rusty.
What's up, Russ?
I've been married 5 years now. My wife, I have two daughters with her. My wife, she wants to have herself a little career, and she's forcing me to stay home now. I don't know what to do with the
I understand how you say somebody's, a woman is forcing you to do anything.
Well, she said that she's going to send Patrice a noose in the oak tree, and he knows what to do with it.
Is that what your wife said?
Yeah.
Or that's what you're saying?
Well, no, that's what she told me.
Oh, just because she's turned, that's because, you know why she want to do that? She want to send good old Patrice a noose in an oak tree.
It's telling
because,
the truth.
Yeah, because she's in fear of you finding out that that horse shit she's trying to pull ain't going to happen to me. And now she can say anything she fucking wants, like, oh, you know, these guys are fucking Neanderthals. But you know what? To be honest with you, you know, I really am a Neanderthal because I like to tap into what Neanderthals didn't deal with. They didn't deal with some bitch going, ugh, you stay home, kid. Me go hunt. Me go hunt whatever the fuck men hunted back then. And I hunt. You stay home with your dick swinging, looking like what I should look like. That's that fucking shit that girls do. Let me tell you something. Let me tell you what you're setting yourself up for when you be a stay-at-home dad. This is what you're going to be, a stay-at-home mom. Because that's what the fuck that she's supposed to be doing. Don't lose your fucking balls like that. And I'm going to tell you why. If you love your woman for her own good, you cannot let her put you in that situation. Because
I'm just afraid I'm going to wake up one morning and she's going to have them sewn on herself.
You know what? But that's it. But see, you can't live in fear. See, women only, there's only a few, and Kathleen is one of them that you meet in this world that are devoid of that thing that women have, that ultra emotion. She's only powerful if you let her be powerful. Meaning, if she probably jokes about it, like if you go, hey, if I fuck another girl, what would you do? You might do hypothetical things like that, and she'll go, well, if you did that, I would sew your balls to your leg. Or my girl, I'm like, if I get caught in the bed, she goes, I'll go bust all your windows out in your truck. Now, I look at it like, I just look at it like, bitch, I don't even believe that hypothetically you wouldn't do that. Because you know why? She's scared. I never put my hand on her, never did nothing like that. But she's scared what I potentially would do. She's afraid of what, you've never introduced her to like a side of you that she doesn't understand. She thinks she gets you. And when a woman thinks she gets you, that's when it's all over. See, here's how it works for a woman. The amount of time that it takes for her to pussy you up is the amount of time that she sticks around to enjoy you being a pussy. So if it took you 5 years to pussy you up, she's going to stick around for 5 years to enjoy you being a pussy. And then she's going to leave you. You understand what I'm saying?
I see where you're going.
So you cannot, you can't just say, hey, bitch, don't work. Because, I mean, if the bitch is bringing home some fucking money, you can't be homeless and a pimp. So it's like, trust me, man, you can't be put in a position where where you let, like, her having more money than you. Because women can't handle that shit. She's not going to be able to handle you having more, like, you having less money than her. She's not going to be able to handle you getting up in the morning, making her fucking breakfast. She can't deal with that. She's going to look at you like a punk. Do you understand? All a woman has in this world is that her man is cool. That's their presentation. If she presents you to the world as my stay-at-home husband, nigga, how can she do that? How can you let her do that? Present you, this is my husband, the wife. Do you understand?
Rusty, what kind of job does she want to get?
Well, she wants to work at some, I guess, some secretary at some office somewhere.
It's
I
not
don't
even
know.
Something.
Okay,
if she's making
that's
six figures.
Do you make enough money for her not to do that?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay.
The point is not whether or not she's working, though.
Hold on a second. Hold on, Rusty. Hold on a second, Dante. From now, when you ask a question, you got to fucking have a point. Now, when you ask this motherfucker what his wife did and what he did, what was your point today?
My point is, if it was a job, like a career job, it's a secretary. It's like a,
right.
You know,
okay.
Whatever.
It don't even fucking matter.
Yeah, or if they need the money, that's significant. That matters.
Well, yeah, but you can't. See, that's the thing. You can't. Listen, Rusty, let me tell you something, man. You got to understand, for the sake of your fucking marriage, you hear me? For the sake of your marriage, do not get put in a position where she thinks you ain't cool. And I know that's some corny shit, but if she can't look at you like my man is the shit, then your marriage is over, because you know that trickles down into your kids. They're going to start going, oh, Dad, you're a faggot. Ask mommy to do it. Do you understand?
Call you a faggot.
Yeah, I don't want that to happen.
Do you understand what I'm saying? Your kids and the people around you, they're all going to start to look at you with a little less of that lore that men have, man. Our walk, our talk, our arrogance. You know why bitches hate me, right? Hate is the same thing as love. If I wasn't arrogant... My girl said the other day, can you get off that pimp shit for once? I go, if I do, bitch, then what? Then what? What you gonna do then? You need an opening to fag me up. Don't let her fag you up, Rusty.
Thanks, boys. I got a customer. I gotta let you go. Thanks for your
time. Damn, fag. Hang up, you pussy. Rusty's a pussy.
He's at work.
And look, and we're going to take a quick break real quick. We're going to come back with, like, all phone calls. So, Paulie, Bob, Scott, Jared, Mike, Oliver. And some bitches call, too, you scary assholes. You can call. I'll listen to you talk about nothing. All right, we'll be back in a second. Bye.
This is a man's world.
Yes, it is. Yeah.
This is a man's world.
I see your face, Kathleen. I see it.
It is.
But it's true.
But it wouldn't be nothing.
We give you a little credit, though. Look.
Without a woman or a girl.
We give you a little credit. See, it gives you a small. Without a woman or a girl, either one, it doesn't
without
really fucking matter.
You see?
Yeah, see? Look.
Man made the car.
That's true.
Man made the car.
It wasn't his car. It wasn't Ellen Ford, bitch. It was
Henry.
Man made the train.
Bitch didn't invent the steam engine. Bitch, no bitches putting coal in the front of that shit. Did you?
Man made the electric light.
Electric light. Thomas Edison. Now that's the Godfather soul giving the white man credit for light.
Man made the boat for the water.
Boats.
Like Noah made the ark.
Yeah.
This is a man.
We did everything.
Man.
Man. Right?
And it wouldn't mean nothing.
It's the name of the movie.
Not a woman on earth.
Without some pussy. All right, thanks. That's basically what he said.
Exactly.
Basically what he means. Basically what Jay Brown
meant. Gotta get some ass.
Think about a little bit of man.
Wait a minute. Basically what he said is, man did everything. And you know what? We need some pussy.
It's nothing without pussy.
Oh, this is a man. Man's world. Oh, hey, bitch. Just suck my dick real quick so I can go invent a boat. He was getting his dick sucked. And he's like, oh.
You know what? We should get something to go in the water.
I need to
travel in the water.
I need to be able to float on water. And then when he shot off, the sperm floated at the top. He said,
I got it.
Oh, boy. We really, really are great motherfuckers.
Absolutely.
And you motherfuckers, y'all are on the attack. Y'all are on the attack to take away what makes us men. That's what you have to do, Kathleen.
I am not on the attack. I think you're just wonderful to treat.
But your sister-in, or whatever you fucking call it.
My sister-in is wants to castrate you. Is that what you're saying?
You know they do. Tell the truth. Don't be scared. Tell the truth.
No.
What do you think the problem is with bitches right now? Like women from, like, say, 25 to 35. What's the biggest problem right now?
I really think that, like your thing with the Brazilian women.
Mm-hmm.
I think that our society, it's not only puritanical in the you know, oppressed. Those aren't the women you're going to meet. The ones that you're going to meet that are, it's just, I don't know. our society.
Do you see that? Even a genius now. She's a genius.
Can't explain.
I'm not
they
a genius.
Don't fucking.
I got it. I
don't
I'll
know.
Explain
and
it.
Here's the great thing. Here's the great
There's
thing.
There's a lot of self-hating women in our society.
I think they're just trying to test you. A woman wants to be protected by her man, and if she can punk you up, how are you going to protect her against another man?
She's always looking to upgrade the protection. Is
That's
that fair
right.
enough?
To upgrade the protection, no.
See, that, do you see? Now, ladies out there, listen to me about how you think. Now, Kathleen, she has a low self-esteem, too, because we always call her a genius and stuff. She kind of goes, I'm not one. She has that little self-esteem thing. But this is the thing. Women never have a plan B with their thinking. That's their fucking problem. Like, she has an opinion, but the next thing that has to come out of her mouth is the reason for the opinion. Men, we pontificate and we're philosophical about anything. This is how men are. Men are like this. It's like we have these kind of conversations. Men can take any juvenile thing and turn it into some type of philosophical thing. Like, we'll go, hey, would you fuck a bitch if she didn't have a knee? Right? Or would you fuck a bitch if she was missing a nose? Now, I'm looking at fucking Than right now when I say that, and the first thing a guy will do is take his two fingers and put it over his bottom
think about
lip
it. Let me think
and
about
rub
that.
Them and go, you know, I don't
think I would fuck a bitch without a nose.
I would fuck a bitch without a nose. Women, you don't embrace hypothetical thought, and you don't embrace, you don't ever need to expand on what you feel. That's why if a woman goes, I don't think, I would never sleep with, I would never have a threesome. And you go, why not? Girls just go, here's their answer. Because.
Disgusting.
It could be just. Bleh. You understand?
Yeah, okay. The thing is, I think.
All right, bitch. Get your 17 thoughts
okay,
together.
No.
Oh, shit. We have a girl calling? Oh. Go ahead, Krista. Krista?
Yeah. Yes.
Don't call. Wait a minute. Calm down now, sweetie. Don't call mad. You don't have to be mad to express how you feel. Just
no, I'm
calm
sorry,
it down.
I'm on a bus. It's just hard for me to hear. So
oh, okay. Damn. You're on a bus. Okay. Go ahead, baby. Go ahead. I can
She's
hear you.
She's a loser.
Hold on.
Okay, good. I think that having a man stay home and be a stay-at-home dad is only equal. I mean, if a woman has been expected to do that for hundreds of years, then
yeah, you should be expected to do it for
thousands of years.
Yeah. Why should this change? Are you motherfucking...
Well, why should... Okay, let me say this. There are a lot of traditions that are not necessarily good traditions. Okay, there is no reason that a woman... Why should a woman be oppressed and be forced to stay home as a stay-at-home mom if she doesn't want to?
It's not
if
a... No. Wait a minute.
Krista,
hold on. I'm not saying...
A career.
I'm not saying, sweetie. I'm not saying you should stay home. But I'm saying you should not make your husband stay home. See, I don't give a fuck what y'all do.
Well, you don't.
Wait a minute, Crystal. It's no, it's not equal. No. Because here's what happens. You talk all the shit you talk, right? And I'm sure you have a boyfriend, right? You got a boyfriend?
Yeah, I have a boyfriend.
Okay, so the way you talking to a strange soldier means you talk to a motherfucker you familiar with even worse. But here's all the shit you talking, right? I bet you go, sweetie, can you open this pickle jar for me? Okay? When it boils down to life, you a girl. You understand? You're a girl. And you
Good
need...
Point.
My point is you're going to need a man to do man shit at some point. But we don't need you to do no
man
shit.
A man to do what?
To open your pickle jar for you.
But see, Krista is not going to have children with a guy like Rusty Knight.
How do you know?
I just isn't it obvious?
No.
This woman.
They all want a strong man.
Krista, here's what your problem is. You don't have anybody to guide you through your attitude right now. Your attitude, you're too comfortable with talking to a guy with this attitude you have. You've never met a guy that made you feel like you want to be second. You understand? Now you need to meet a guy that's gonna direct you into the direction that you're gonna feel, because your real nature is to want to look at me and love me.
If I take his advice, second. If I take his advice, or if I feel that he's more has greater expertise.
She has a problem with the semantics. That's what it is.
That's not being second. Yeah. That's not being controlled. That's just saying.
I'm not saying control a bitch.
You're a better judgment.
I'm saying control a bitch. I'm saying that she has to look at you. You have to look at a motherfucker like he's the shit. And how can you look at him like he's the shit if he's a stay-at-home fucking dad?
Well, guess what? You can look at a woman like she's the shit. Just because she stays, you know, she can still be the shit.
Sure you can, but that's not what's in question.
Yeah, that's
not what's in question. Why you have a problem with the semantics of it? Women are women, men are men. There are things that are innately. Yes, they are. That's why you have a pussy and we got a vagina.
Exactly. You're always. Krista.
They are not the same. It's not no such thing as different and equal. There's no such thing as things cannot be different and equal. They're different because they're different. You have a problem.
We're not all that different.
Yes, we are.
We're big time.
Extremely different.
Part of that is culturally defined.
But we're not talking culture.
Krista,
we're not talking culture. We're talking nature. Like the nature of fucking. Let's boil it down to the rule. When we fuck, okay. Right? Have you ever fucked a guy?
I'm
of course
she whether
has.
I have or have not on the radio.
Well, okay, of course you have. You're not a fucking virgin, Krista.
He's
but
saying
basically,
in order to have sex, a woman has to submit.
Yes, you are.
She has to open
fuck,
her legs.
You're the fucky.
She has. She
no
has
matter
to,
what you do, you are the fucky. And that's what it boils down to. When it boils
well,
down
I
to
imagine,
the rule, it's the fuck.
Okay,
you are
all,
being fucked.
A woman has to accept the penis into her.
Exactly.
Body.
Yes.
Exactly.
Yes.
That she has to accept other things going into her life.
Like what don't you...
It's a metaphor, but it does not have to apply across the board. You
yes,
are generalizing. You're making a sweeping generalization. You're
yeah, but you know what? We have to make a sweeping generalization because, look, if you take a poll, you don't poll everybody. If I poll, I've done field research, Krista. This is field research. It works. Trust me. If your girl, if you don't think your man is cool, which you don't think your man is cool, because my bitch would
of
never...
I think my man is cool.
You can't think he's cool because you talk to men this way. So that means you talk to him the way you're trying to talk to me. Thank you.
Rude or aggressive?
Yes.
Both.
Yes.
I'm simply making a point.
Okay,
and
fair
you
enough.
Are...
Go ahead.
No.
See how she's calming down a little bit.
And, you know, you're not...
There you go,
pumpkin. You're only seeing things... In one direction.
See, you're starting to. You know what happened now?
Submit.
Let me tell you.
Well, why should a woman submit if a man doesn't want to?
Because a woman has to submit.
Do you hear? Now, okay, cut her. Hang up on her. Thanks, Krista. Krista, thanks. I hang up on you, but if you're still listening, thank you for calling. Listen, do you see how she was calming down a little bit? Women only got about 4 levels to their emotion. And after she gets to the 5th one, she's like, now she made 2 or 3 points. After the 4th point, she goes, because it never needs to get past the 3rd level. Guys have to have.
And that's whose fault is that? That's our fault.
That's fucking
her our
man's
fault for allowing her to take his place as a man. Because she's fucking with a bitch. Her man's a bitch. And that's how she feels comfortable talking to men like that. Check your hoes.
No, I disagree. I think there are plenty of men that, you know, like Krista.
They all like it. They're like anything that got a pussy. Guys like anything that's got a pussy. But the point is, we're not ready to take a loss. That somebody, she's probably cute. Somebody wants to fuck her and they're willing to put up with all her shit until they get tired of it. And then they're going to fuck her sister because she gets on her on their nerves as much as they do. So.
And we're going to go to, we're going to Oliver in St. Louis. Oliver.
What's up, Patrice? How you doing, my brother?
What's going on, man?
Man, you know, dude, there are some fucking pussy-ass motherfucking guys out there. Pussy control. Like Prince said, you have to exercise pussy control. Any man in his right mind would love to stay home with the fucking kids and not work, get high, jack off, and watch porn all day. What the fuck is the problem with that? You gotta have pussy control. That's the problem.
But you see the point he's making?
He's
Wait
saying...
a minute. No. Hmm. See, this is the thing. Like, a lot of people have a natural gut thought, right? But then take the gut, push it to the mind, and figure out what the fuck's going on, right? The point, what he's saying is that you can stay home, right?
Still be masculine.
And still be the motherfucker. But you have to set it up that way. You can't have your woman set you up to be her wife. You have to set her up. If you want to be that motherfucker that's lazy or sit on the couch or whatever the fuck you want to do, and you, and I mean, it's going against nature because a woman really respects a hunter. If you, if she don't feel like you out there hunting and gathering, it, it automatically it reverses the situation. So you are bringing yourself into a bad spot. But at the same time, here's what ends up happening with stuff, with shit like that, when you get a bum guy who's still the master of his domain, is that he hits women. Because that, that he has boiled it down to the fucking...
the root.
The fucked upness, which is no matter what a woman does, we'll still be able to kick your ass. But when you got to start thinking like that, that's when it starts to be a lost thing. That's not pimping. That's like... that's like fucking, it's just
pimping.
Abuse, right? You're just choking a bitch and she's afraid of you. But you gotta get, you gotta convince a bitch, you gotta convince a girl that working, working and me staying home is the best thing. You know what I'm saying?
And I'll tell you what, dude, the worst thing that ever happened to me and interrupted, it happened in this country, man, is fucking women's lip. I'll tell you that.
No, that's
women's
not,
lip?
That's not
like,
true.
Jesus Christ.
That's totally
women's
true.
Lip.
That's not true. Women's lip, dude. I'm gonna tell you, it's just like the civil rights movement. It's a mindset. It's you can't change the thought process with legislation. Like, okay, I think that being an asshole is the only way to introduce a certain thought. Cause just when women's lib happened, you still got motherfuckers like Oliver. You still got motherfuckers like Jared and Paulie and me who are frustrated.
Women's lib is like from 1970.
Yeah,
that's bull.
Wait a minute though.
He's talking about the concept.
The context of this though, man. Listen, man. The problem with women's lib is not women's lib itself. It's the fact that you're forcing men to feel
it's what they were allowed to do.
Exactly. So we're trying to. This show, it because of women's lib, this is what is done. And this is what civil rights has done, too. I want to talk to a white boy about racism. I want this motherfucker to be frothing at the mouth, to think nigga, to think spick, to think fucking hang you in a tree, so I can have that dialogue with him, and he doesn't feel like, because society has told him he better think this way. Right. I don't want to have a dialogue with an oppressed motherfucker. See, I don't want to have a dialogue with an oppressed... women shouldn't want to have dialogue with oppressed men. See, this guy, if he works for a living, he goes out and he has to work with women and go, "Hi, how are you, bitch, today? I have to listen to your horse shit. Hello, I have to pretend I don't want to suck your titty today. Hello, yes, woman boss, holy shit, cunt." You have to deal with that, and it makes you more angry. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, but for the last, like, 10, 15 years...
go ahead.
The last 10, 15 years, there's been a backlash. More women are staying home and raising children.
Here's the problem with women's lib. Women's lib, the liberation of women was not to liberate
it's not
women.
Even an
it was
issue.
To make women
it's not
men.
Relevant.
To put women in a position of men, how
well,
men are today.
That's
not to
the
liberate them
cunt,
as women.
Cunt face.
Exactly.
That's exactly. This is a girl, and this is very prevalent in comedy. They, you know, I'm like a guy. You're not a guy. You're not one of the boys.
And never will be.
You won't
yeah.
be.
Never will be.
When, yeah. when have you ever heard
exactly.
ever a guy in comedy, like a guy, and growing up. See, this is the thing that women are so, why are you so against what men say? It's like you've never heard guys go, "Hey man, let's all hang out with Susan. She's a funny motherfucker. Oh, she's the funniest. She be farting sometimes and shit. She be making jokes. She be hanging up on people. She be flashing them." When the fuck have you ever heard of a woman being fun?
Women are fun.
For women, not
yeah.
for men.
Yeah.
Yeah. When we're drunk.
There you go. Hold on. Hey, we're gonna go to what is his name? What's this fucking Damon? Damon, what's up?
Yo.
Go ahead.
Hey, fellas. So, yeah, I got this new girlfriend. I'm 26. She's young. She's 18.
Ooh, delicious.
And my first black girl. I'm really excited
Holy
about it.
Holy shit.
Yeah, nappy dugout.
Yeah, I'm really,
does she got,
she's way fucking out of my league, too.
Does she got pussy hair?
Better looking than she knows yet.
She got pussy. Is she shaved?
Shave.
Does she shave? She shaved? Is she shaved?
Does she no, actually, it's a fucking mess down there.
Oh my God! It looks like a the early scenes of King Kong.
They're like Christy Love.
That bitch is kinky. That bitch's pussy like looked like an alligator skin wallet. Wait, was it scary? Was it scary when you first went down there?
I was really, she's so fucking good, like way out of my league, good looking. I was so excited to get down there.
Light skin, dark skin, what?
Dark skin, she's amazing ass. She's a beautiful girl. She smells really strongly, like more than I'm used to, but I mean, she's so fucking hot that I love that.
Oh,
smell.
Her pussy stinks?
Is it stink or is it like strong?
Not bad, but just strong. Like, dude. I don't know. She got wet as hell.
Dude, so you say she's, wait a minute, so she, delicious. you say she's out of your league, you're saying, right?
Physically, yeah, absolutely.
Okay, here it is. Here's what you do. Now, I'm going to tell you real quick. You got to, sometimes you got to pray on some low self-esteem situation. Sometimes you got to do it. I mean, listen, I'm a fat motherfucker.
We'll see.
You have to learn. Wait a minute. You have to learn. It's like, okay, you got to introduce certain things a little bit, right? Now, you go down on all the time?
Well, it's kind of new. It's only like 2 months now. I've gone on down there like two times. But here's the thing. Like, it's not... I don't understand a pussy at all. Like, I don't know how you're supposed... Like, I know where all the parts are. I know where the fucking clit is. I know where the whole... I know what you're supposed to do and what they do on porn and shit. I don't think I do a good job. Like, I'm a fucking...
Why? What does she do? Now, okay, first of all, let's face it. She don't think you do a good job.
No, definitely not.
So dude, you feel... Does she say to you that you don't do a good job, or her reaction is that you don't do a good job?
Well, here's the... Okay, so the other day, I'm down there, and she's not reacting at all. Like, I can tell that she's kind of putting on a show a little bit.
Right.
Yeah.
So I say to her, I say, you got to teach me how to touch your pussy right, because every girl is different. And she gives me
nigga.
Wait.
No, shut up.
All right, guys.
Listen to me. We have to heal you. Look it. I understand what you're saying.
I can walk through it.
You can't. Why the fuck a woman
you
gonna
can walk you through
yeah,
your pussy?
That's what I'm talking about.
You can walk through your pussy. How you like your pussy?
Technical.
Dude,
it's not none of this bullshit.
Listen, dude. Like, here's the first thing.
It's
like when you shut the fuck up, please. When you say like if I cut you off, I have to cut you off right when you say something that's leading you in the wrong direction. You understand what I'm saying? So I'm not cutting you off just to talk right now, but when you say, hey, I ask her to teach me, that is no number fucking 26 on the no list. You do not ask a bitch how to please her. Because she going to tell you how to please her the way the last motherfucker told it to.
Right.
Do you understand what I'm saying? So that's already putting you in a bad fucking spot. If you don't know how to eat pussy, you pretend you do until you really learn. Now, my particular thoughts on eating pussy, now we'll give you three different ideas of eating pussy. I'm going to tell you my idea first, okay? And one thing, never forget, this is what I believe in about eating pussy. Whatever technique you use, don't do another one. So if you got to poke your tongue in and out like a lizard technique, just do that. It's very rhythmic. Don't fucking poke it, then kiss it, then punch it. Don't do it because they have to build up. You ever jerk your dick? You ever have a bitch jerk your dick and she's just bad at it?
Yeah.
And because she don't know, because she'll jerk it down and then she'll go in. She'll do it how she thinks is good. See, the ego, erase the ego. Do it how you think she's going to like it, and you stick with it. Even if it's boring for you, it won't be boring for her. Now, here's my technique, and we'll go across the board. I take two thumbs, and I spread the clitoris, but my thumb is above the hood. Like, it's at the pussy meat part. Like, if you come down, there's the hood, and then there's like a meaty part on the side. You spread that, and you slide the hood up so that the clitoris is showing. And you got to learn how to wag your tongue to the left and right as fast as you fucking can. And the tip of your tongue hit the tip of her clit, and you just go until she comes. Don't move. Don't fucking just stay in that spot, and she will build up. She can sit there with that I'm ignoring you shit, but she's not going to be able to do it. You understand, this is field research, nigga. I've told a bitch, right? I've said, look, she get a call. I go, stay on this call. Right? And let me eat your pussy and focus on your call. No bitch has been able to finish the phone call yet. You understand what I'm saying? So that's my technique. Now, what's hold on. Let's go. We'll go to Kathleen because she thinks she knows technique. Then go to Don Shig.
Okay, I just, first of all, I agree with you. Don't ask her. That's like annoying. And once you're not, it's, ugh, God, really annoying. But right under the clit, right under the hood, the pressure right there. And I would just suggest to
pressure,
go.
What pressure?
Put the pressure,
with
whatever it is, a tongue, a penis.
Well, he's talking
right
about eating pussy. He needs to know the best way to eat the pussy.
You know what? If you put it directly on the clit, it's annoying. It's just
okay,
annoying.
Okay, ready? Now, ready? Now, here's...
And she's going to act like she likes it just so you'll leave her alone.
Now, do you hear this? This is my...
Yeah,
my
nobody fucking knows the answer.
No,
that's why I asked.
Dude.
No,
this
right.
is the point. This is why we have to introduce them to what we want to be the proper way. Basically, what I'm saying is, that's good for her. You know why? Because some goofy guy... ate her pussy exactly how she wanted to, and then your girl, some goofy guy, ate her pussy exactly how he. My particular way, I think, is the way, because I practice on some third world pussy. I ain't gonna lie to you, I practice on third world pussy where niggas fly in the fuck, and I will be honest, and it works on those hoes too. Now I'm saying my technique: you spread it, you flap the tongue, you flap the tongue over that clit. Right on it. It might be a little sensitive, but you just back off a little bit. But what you do is you manipulate the clit. You got to pull the hood back. And if she goes, oh, I don't like that, you figure it out.
All women are built a little different. Yeah.
Yes. And
like
here's
if anyone did...
Here's another thing. Here's another thing, dude. Here's another thing. Here's another thing I will add is that you have to be a pussy eater. You can't just eat pussy. And I'm explaining what that means. Meaning, I only like my dick sucked by a woman who's a dick sucker, who doesn't even care that I'm there. She just needs to suck a dick. And the point that I'm there with my dick doesn't really mean that much to her. She just wants to suck a dick. You have to be so willing to bring her pleasure that you are a pussy eater. Learn how to eat pussy the way you need to.
You gotta eat pussy because you like eating pussy,
motherfucker.
And if
no
she says fuck me, fuck me, then look, bitch,
the,
I'm
yeah,
not
pussy
finished.
And if it stinks, let me tell you something. You eat pussy. Here's what you do: you fight through the stink, right, until you learn how to eat pussy correctly, and then you stop eating that pussy, and you say, sweetie,
stinks.
Yeah, sometimes it's tough to go down there. It smells like goddamn
like
Africa.
Hot garbage. It's like warm monkey piss.
It smells like the tip of a spear. what's your technique, Don?
Thanks
for calling, dude. I appreciate it, man. So we tell you.
I take the right hand and pull up on the abdomen so that the hood slides back on and I go underneath the clit.
That's interesting.
Yeah, I'll talk to you later, Kathleen.
Look at Kathleen. She don't even know. Oh, that's good.
You push on the abdomen, slide it back so the hood is exposed. Then once I get the hood exposed, I take my upper teeth and hold the hood back.
Ain't that dangerous?
No, you just put the pressure on it, hold the hood back, and then I go underneath the hood.
With the tongue.
Right under the clit. Right underneath the clit.
Right.
With the tongue.
Yeah, with the tongue.
Mm-hmm.
And so that you don't have
now
to...
This been field research.
Absolutely. This way you can work both nipples.
Has it been field research?
Absolutely. You can work...
In third world countries, nigga.
No, but I have fucked a escort, a hooker for... I used to date a hooker.
Oh,
for
wow.
6 months.
She
fell in love
so
with me.
She would know.
My shit has been proven on strange pussies on 5 different continents.
I think Don technique.
I got shit.
That I can visualize.
Kathleen gave me the nod.
Yeah, I'm sorry, Patrice.
You goofy bitch.
No.
You just like Dante.
Shut the fuck up. I could visualize working.
You can't visualize spread with your thumb?
Yeah, it might hurt. It's like
he's doing the same thing as
me. You know what? Let me tell you what. Kathleen probably could do multiple orgasms.
Don't think pressing on the
and
stomach
that's why she's
fucking...
so sensitive. The clit is too sensitive. But you can adjust that. You can adjust the pressure.
Yeah.
Which one?
Is
it? This one?
What
which one was?
For you like?
Another guy. It was a Jared?
When we give the number.
No, we got
Where's the fucking guy that we was gonna talk to right? going for a second. What kind of wife? Oh, he hung up on a motherfucker? Sorry.
Oh, he might have just hung up himself, too.
Nah, sorry, man. How about,
Who do you like? This one.
Oh. Ooh, this is good. Yeah. Fucking, yeah. Mr. Jared, right?
Or Jason?
No, Jason. Holy shit. Jason in Philly, nigga. God, Jason.
What's poppin', fellas?
Oh, shit.
What up,
oh,
pimp?
Oh, nigga. Wait, but this story, I don't know about this. Because if he's a pimp, he wouldn't be asking. He's trying to get out of a bind, nigga. Go ahead.
No, I ain't in a bind, man. I'm just asking advice, general advice. Now, I got a chick that I've been with for 3 years. Mm. Right? Now, we just found out recently he was having a kid.
Right.
Now, I had a child from a previous relationship that's like 10 years old, and I've been doing my thing with her the whole time. Now, we keep it real with each other. She got a man. She knows I'm with this chick or whatever. But just out of respect, do I need to tell her that I'm having a kid with the chick that I'm with now? Or should
you
I
should.
Just let it ride?
So now he's with the girl for 10 years?
She will find out, and it's better that if she does it through you.
She's got a man, and you've been fucking around with her for 10 years.
Yeah.
This nigga here, Dante,
I'm working this out.
Yeah, Dante is fucked up. Like I say, look at dude. I say you tell the bitch. I firmly believe in this honesty shit. And when you tell her, the attitude, Jason, has to be Dante. This
you
is
don't
fucked
tell
up.
Shit.
Hold up. I say you tell the bitch, and this is how I say you tell it. I say you tell it like. I was trying to get rid of you anyway. That's how you got to tell the story. But don't say that to her, but you say it like, you know what, I'm really happy that I have a baby with this other bitch. I kind of like her better in a way that's not saying that. That's my personal opinion. I don't believe in lying because I'm like with Kathleen on that shit. I don't want a bitch finding out. Like, because that really does lower the
your
pimp
status.
It lowers your status in the pimp club because if she finds out you're just a scary, you know, motherfucker who will lie about anything, then you can't really pimp your way out of that. But you just go, you know what? We do what we... First of all, she knows you do what you do.
Right.
You just throw that shit back up in her face. Like, bitch, you know we do what we do.
How we
now,
get down.
I fuck you with no rubber. What you think? I'm going to downgrade another bitch? I got to fuck her with no... I got to fuck her without a condom too, nigga. But Dante, I think, look, my advice, and evidently Kathleen's advice, you tell a bitch. But
I
want to
say this, lie, 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 lie.
Don't come up, I ain't going to say nothing.
Lie.
Oh,
right,
no.
If that's what
you
I'm saying.
You tell her.
If it don't come up, you got to lie. Let me tell you something. Women will always, if you don't lie, they'll create their own lie. They just need some fabric of truth to hold on to so they can make their own movie about what is most comfortable with them so they can move on, not be a hoe, not be a bitch that ain't shit, and still maintain their dignity. Lie, 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 lie.
Well, I'm saying, I'm not trying to lose this chick, though. That's the thing. I'm not.
Tell the truth, then.
Yeah.
Tell the fucking. Because I'm telling you, though, that's more.
If
you
want to
keep
her,
tell her. If you looking to have an issue, nigga, I'm telling you, man, don't tell her Dante's way. It's like the stars have to line up correctly every day and shit. You know what I'm saying? The stars have to be right. Jupiter got to be lined up correctly with Mars, and she have to never know. But how the fuck you going to come on with other diaper smell on? You know what I'm saying? You're going to be smelling like somebody else's baby shit, nigga. Women know shit like that.
They'll,
who you been kissing?
Sure.
Whose baby's diaper you been changing?
She'll find
nigga?
Out.
What you doing? Baby powder on your fingers. Tell this bitch that you got another chick pregnant. She's gonna be mad.
She won't find out.
But it's better. Yeah. It's better if you tell the truth and give it to a straight nigga like medicine than if you fucking lie about it, dude, and she find out. That's my fucking personal opinion. All right, Jason, man. Good luck with that, nigga.
All right.
We're gonna go to Mr. Scott in Ohio.
In Ohio, right?
Scott.
Yeah.
Go ahead, man.
All right, Patrice, here's the story, dude. All right, I was at this bar about 2 days ago. I met this girl. I just fell in love with her, but I was fucking hammered at the time. So I wrote my number on her hand. I didn't hear from her for like 2-3 days. Finally, she calls me. So I did what any good soldier did. I asked her, you know, let's go out on a date. She kind of played it off like, you know what, she didn't really want to go, but she did want to go. So I'm just trying to think, man, if I do go out on with her, how should I play it, man? Because I can't read her, and usually I can read a girl pretty good, but I really pretty much dig this chick, and I'm just wondering what you think I should do.
Well, you don't even know if you like her. Well, you just met her.
No, he does. He's
you met her in a bar, and you were both really
gorgeous?
Drunk.
Hold up, is she gorgeous?
Dude, she's probably like I'm pretty good looking. I'm a pretty good looking dude, but she's probably out of my league.
Listen, man, listen to me. Here's the situation with that. You can't. How old are you, man? Like 21 or some shit?
I'm 23.
23. See, when you're giving advice, man, there's young guy advice. We gotta get somebody young in this motherfucker too, man. Because I'm 36, Dante's 30 something, and Kathleen's 40, 45 or whatever the fuck she is.
I'm 58.
But old school advice is this: I don't play around with the pussy, right? When I meet a bitch, I call her in the next second. You understand what I'm saying? Because if she's under, say when she met you, she was under some influence, even if she was sober. If she was under, like, sometimes I call it temporary insanity. Like, because I'm a fat motherfucker. When I fuck a girl, I even fuck my girlfriend like it's the last time. Because I think that eventually she will wake up from her coma or whatever the fuck is causing her to fuck me. So whatever she did that made you think she was under some type of influence, you better take full advantage of the fact that she might be under some crazy shit. She's looking for something. First of all, her reaction to not calling you and not going out right away or being apprehensive tells me that she is a hoe and you can get some pussy quick. And I'm going to tell you why. Because women, when they're hoes, they try to do anything not to look like one. They need that thing to make them, what's the word, like you need to give
validate
the fact that she's a hoe. I'm telling you, the fact that you met, let's think about it. You met her in a bar. You put a number on her hand. That's not a classy chick. Let's be honest here. She kept that number in her fucking hand, okay, which means she didn't wash her hands at some point.
Dirty bitch.
Let's be honest here. So that means she called you a couple of days later. She probably thinks you're a little bit hotter than you think yourself, okay?
Right.
You take her out. What you do is you treat her, because if she's really pretty, what that means is she rolls in a community where guys fuck girls like her, okay? So she might be looking at you like, you know what? I'm ready for some downgrade love. Meaning a guy who's kind of cute, right? Not ugly enough for people to go, why are you dating him? But she don't think you're going to treat her like shit. You understand what I'm saying? So what you do is you do the whole dating thing once or twice at the most, nigga. Because you don't want to do what other motherfuckers don't do. You don't want to be taking her out and other motherfuckers just fuck her in the mouth in the first date. You don't want to do that shit. Here's what you do. You take her out on one or two dates, and then you start pushing up on her. And if she don't want to give you no pussy, you don't go, fuck you, this and that. You just you always love them and leave them. Give them a kiss on the cheek, pet her on the head, say, thank you, sweetie, but I don't feel comfortable going out with you 2, 3, 4 times, man, because I'm a virile young man who needs to fuck. I want to be spending my time fucking, not trying to fuck you. I know I want you now. Do you want me? You got to make her ante up. You understand? Make her ante up. Say, I want you, and I'm gonna take you out. You could be lying, though, but I'm going to take you out after this. I'm going to feed you after this. I'm going to love you after this. But you know what? Don't fucking force me to go spend time that you think it was written in a book. I'm supposed to go out with you 5 times before I can get a kiss. Fuck that. This is 2000 and motherfucking 12 or whatever date it is. Nigga, Arabs are trying to kill us. We ain't got time to be fucking around with that bullshit. You understand? You understand?
Yeah, bro.
So take her out once or twice, and she'll give you some pussy, because this girl gives up pussy. She's downgrading because she's dating guys that treat her like dog shit. You understand?
Dude, she just broke up with a guy, too.
Exactly. And he treated her like dog shit. So she's looking for Captain Smoochie to hold and come carry her away. I'm not that nigga. Fuck that shit. My girl's a hoe. She came in a hoe. But I'm going to tell her like this. You ever fuck a girl and you make love to her, right? And then she breaks up with you, and the one thing that's hurting you is that I didn't fuck her like it was the last time.
She was a dirty
I fuck girl. Look, you're going to get fucked like it's the last time every time because the bitch could wake up. So listen, take her out, but always keep sexual innuendo there. And if she tries to say things like, I don't want to, don't say that to me.
Shut up.
You just go, look, bitch, I'm not the nigga. You ain't making me into Sir Lancelot, ho. I'm going to feed you because you hungry. I'm going to put a coat on you because you cold. But you're going to fuck me because I'm horny. You understand, Scott? You're a soldier.
Hey, Patrice, man, you have graduated. I promote you from the category of soldier to general, my friend.
All right, nigga. Go out there. Get him. All right, bye. All right, we're going to take a quick break, man. We're going to get back to these calls, man. There's some people online that we'll get to you. All right, bye.
Love and happiness. Wait a minute, something's going wrong. Someone's on the phone. 3 o'clock in the morning.
Oh, yeah, nigga.
Talking about how she can make it right.
What?
Yeah.
What did that bitch say?
Yeah. Happiness is when
yeah.
you really feel good.
Oh.
Somebody.
Mm.
There's nothing wrong. Someone.
Nothing wrong.
Yeah.
But you gotta make sure, nigga, you got shit right, nigga. You gotta make sure you run shit, though.
Love that happened.
That's right, bitch. Is what I say?
Love.
Go ahead, ho. That's what I said.
Oh, woo.
Yeah. Oh, my God, nigga. Thank you, Danny, sir. Appreciate that. Folks, welcome back to the Black Phillip Show with Patrice O'Neill, with guest host Dante Nero and Kathleen Roll, who's, it's not Kathleen Hole, by the way, it's Kathleen Roll, not Hole with a W. And you call 866-WOW1-WOW, and for the dummies, it's 866, like me, I hate when motherfuckers go, WOW1-WOW, I got to figure it out, 866-969-1969. We're going to line one with Mike, nigga. Mike?
Go, Mike.
Yeah, what's going on?
Nothing.
Yeah, what's up, Patricia? I got a situation for you. This may sound outrageous, but it's the truth. So I'm 23, right, and I'm dating this older woman. She's 28.
Mm-hmm.
Now, like, we've just been seeing us for, like, 6 to 8 months, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
But the thing is, like, when I hit it, like, she only give me ass sex, dog. Like, she don't give us a pussy or she don't suck no dick.
Let me tell you something. I got my friend Dante here. I have my theories, but he has experience with this. And
yeah.
And I think he has a lot more experience with this particular situation than I do. I'm going to let him go with this.
I used to fuck a hooker. Actually, I was fucking a hooker for a year and a half. And so she used to sell pussy, but she kind of like fell in love with me, right?
Mm-hmm.
So
mm-hmm.
she would only let me fuck her in the ass because she, in her mind, she felt that it represented some level of intimacy. Which this goes to what I'm saying about how women create the lie. Like, she's a hoe. And no matter whether she's fucking me in the ass, I'm fucking her in the ass or the pussy or whatever, the bottom line is she's a hoe, but in her mind, it was more personal and more intimate in the ass than it
right.
was in
so
the pussy.
That the theory,
or
the
she could be attracted to the fact that it's just kind of wrong,
and dirty.
She doesn't want to get into the contraceptive.
But, that, but you know what, that
I've had women tell me that about any woman that likes ass sex.
But we got to investigate his thing, though, more thorough.
That's like she will not let you have vaginal sex.
What
with
happens
her, right?
when you try to stick it in a pussy?
Like I'll try it. She's like, no, stop, whatever. Like, she'll hit me that, like, every once in a while, but like you can tell like she don't like it or whatever.
Is
like,
it raw?
Like
is it raw in the booty?
I don't know. You know what I'm saying? Like,
no, is it raw? Do you use a
condom?
Condom
or you
yeah.
Just...
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
She might like it. There's a lot of things, dude. She could be trying to save your life.
Now,
I strapped twice, so, you know, that's what it is. Is this your
girlfriend? Is this, or do you?
No, it's not really. It's not serious okay. like that.
Oh, you know, so you know what?
She likes this guy for aspect because it's wrong.
It's, no. Yeah. Maybe, but no.
Yeah,
here's what it is, dude. She got somebody she loves out there. If y'all just fucking around, it's a separation of what's special and what's not. She's giving you the non-special shit. Like some bitches let you fuck them in the ass and they think they still a virgin. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Uh-huh.
It's mentally. Yeah. But this chick, if y'all are just messing around a little bit, she don't let Mr. I Love You fuck her in the ass. So what it is you are the dirty ass fucker that she wants.
It is what it is.
So don't sweat it and don't do no pussy ass shit like ask her. Just keep fucking her in the butt. You understand?
Whatever, bitch.
Just fuck it. Alright, man. Thank you for calling, man.
Alright, welcome to G's Bar.
Take care. Jared from Virginia. Sorry, dude, to hold you so long, pumpkin. What's going on? Jared?
Hey, Patrice, it's Jared. How we doing, buddy?
How you doing, Jared?
Okay, got a question for you there. I've been dating a girl for about a year. She's extraordinarily independent. I'm talking about to the point where, I mean, she won't let me, you know, change the oil in her car. She won't let me take care of her when she's sick. That kind of thing. How do you suggest I go about dealing with it?
That's
just don't change her oil and leave her alone when she's sick.
Really? Hold on, Jared. Let me just tell her to shut the fuck up once again. What the fuck? Did you just... What is this, beat the clock, bitch? You think you just got to buzz in with something and it made no sense?
No, it made perfect sense. This, like, nigga, what? If she doesn't want you to change your oil, then don't.
It's not that simple. It ain't. Yeah. It ain't what you think it is.
It
goes back. You know what it goes back to, dude? It goes back to the conversation we was having about women's lib. Women don't want anything to do with a man doing anything for them. Let me give you an example. In Australia, right? I went to Australia. Fucked a couple of bitches there, by the way.
Absolutely.
I went to Australia, and bitches in Australia, Melbourne, they will not let you buy them a drink. And this is the mentality behind that. Because they think that if you buy them a drink, now you're in control. So basically, here's this chick. She's a suspicious... she's like a suspicious woman who does not, she's a little afraid of giving control.
Connected.
She's a control freak. And so what that means is she doesn't want you to do anything that you can hold against her, which means she's the mirror image of that shit, which means that she will want to do things for you. I'll give you a perfect example. My ex-girlfriend, when I first met her, the bitch used to buy food for me. And this is before I knew any better. I'm 22 or whatever. Mm-hmm. So I would go, okay, you buy food. Okay. Then every time I reach, and here's a classic motherfucking pimp situation. No matter what you do in your life, you never, ever... This nigga's kids and shit. You listening, nigga?
Okay. I got you.
All right, listen. When it's called reaching in your pocket. Never, ever don't reach in your pocket. Like, if your girlfriend goes, no, I got it, or if she goes, no, I'll buy that, or no, let me do that, you don't let her. You argue with her if you need to let you do that. Because what happens is she's trying to gain a power move on you. This is progressive woman shit. Put it this way. Let's boil it down to the rule again. How can she look at you like a man, like she blinking at you thinking, man, I need this motherfucker, he's so cool, if the bitch won't let you change her tire? She's trying to keep you even, and if you do anything, she's going to come back and think that she's going to be looking at you that you're going to have some power over, like you're going to go, hey, bitch, I changed your tires. That's what she's afraid of, that you're going to come back and throw
look
that shit
I,
in her
what
face.
I did for you.
But you have to stand strong on being a man, Jared. You cannot let a woman negotiate your manhood for you, because you know what? You have an inclination, a natural inclination to change her tire. You just want to do that shit, don't you? You just want to fucking do it.
I've tried to explain that to her. I've tried to say, look, I want to do it.
I feel like it's my place to change her tire. It's my place to take care of her.
Here's what you stop doing.
I'm sure she appreciates that, but maybe, she knows how to change your oil and she's afraid you'll screw it up.
You fucking idiot.
That is the dumbest shit ever.
Do you understand?
I really don't think that's the case.
Exactly. Do you see why? This is why I keep this bitch around.
No.
She always is going to fucking constantly. Did you just see how she affirmed that bullshit? What bitch knows how to change oil and wants
to? I do.
Shut up!
No, I would totally let this guy change my oil.
Why would you give him advice against what you would naturally do?
Yeah, but see, maybe she knows how to change it and is afraid he'll screw it up.
It doesn't fucking matter.
I don't know.
It's
that could be
that.
The case.
It's a lot deeper than that.
It's a control. They're afraid.
No, it's not.
Listen,
it's not about deeper than that.
Listen. All right, listen. Let me tell you something. My girl, right? Here's the shit she did one day. She didn't have no money, so the bitch needed some money to go get some dry cleaning out the store. She needed a dry cleaner, right? So it's a Sunday. So she goes like this. She goes, I'm building something in the house. I'm putting something together. And she goes, I was going to go get my dry cleaning, but I'll wait for you. I go, well, no, bitch, you got a car. Go get it. And no, I'll just wait till you're done. And I go, for what? Oh, nothing. I got a check coming in, I'll go cash the check. Bitch, what check you gonna cash on a Sunday? What the fuck you talking about? Let me tell you what she was doing. She was wanting me to be here's a bitches in a nutshell.
She didn't.
She has. They have ego, and at the same time,
arrogant.
They have. They don't know how to be humble, and at the same time. Need you. So they need you, but they're arrogant at the same time. So she needed money, but instead of asking me for money, which would humble her too much, she tried to manipulate me into offering to be a man. Do you understand what I'm saying? And that is their fucking problem, is that they're egotistical motherfuckers who at the same time need you to open the pickle jar. So basically, this chick don't need you to fucking do the tires, but let me tell you what you do. If she gonna act like she don't need you to do anything for, this is what you're gonna do. I'm gonna back it up to Kathleen's point. You know what? Don't do the other shit that she needs you to do. Because you can't, that's the control. It's like, oh nah, no motherfucker, I know how to do this, and the only reason that I fucking gonna do this is cause I can't. So you do it. And she probably going to do it angry like that. Like, motherfucker, lift this motherfucking shit up for me because I can't. Faggot. That's how women are.
That goes it goes all to one thing. Take your ball and go home. You have a kid, you go and you say, well, you're playing ball in the park and you say, well, I want to bat first. And they say, well, you can't bat, but you can play. You say, all right, well, I'm taking my ball and my bat and I'm going home. Don't play the game. If you play the game, you can always lose the game.
I have a personal
All right, thanks
life.
For calling, dude. Okay. Thank you, Jack, for calling, man.
No problem.
I had a guy, I was putting together a bookshelf, an IKEA bookshelf, and he offered to do it, and I knew, like, he wanted to. He was the man.
Did you screw it up.
Yes, I let him.
Did you know how to do it?
I did know how to do it. Okay. And I was doing it, and he totally offered, and I let him do it. It fell apart. Okay. It just wasted time.
So what are you saying?
That might be the case with the oil.
Not with no oil and no changing the tire.
Maybe it's like a weird car that you need to.
Why do you
like
have faith, Dante?
Dog?
Why do you have faith in her that this story is valid? That why are you accepting the fact that she says she put that motherfucking thing
I'm
together?
I'm telling you, she
I don't
may,
accept that you put it together.
Yes, I can totally put together an IKEA bookshelf.
Nigga, I have problems putting together an IKEA bookshelf. When did you become fucking
It's not easy, but I know how to do it.
This nigga from PBS that...
I knew how to do it.
Bitch Vila. I got to believe you because you're saying it?
Yes. I had two of them. I had already done one, and it is difficult, but I had already done one.
Okay.
And this guy insisted.
So why
that
didn't you not be?
It.
Why didn't you
I
not
did.
Be phony
I
and say
let
no?
Him, I did say you know let that was it. That's how I learned my lesson.
All right, fair enough. Okay, look. Okay.
Well, that's what he should have done was this, let him do it.
This show
he
is
insisted.
This
yeah.
show is built on generalizations. okay? We're going to generalize that most bitches can't put together IKEA shelf and at the same time will not want to, even if she could figure it out. We do have exceptions to the rule, like fucking Captain
Bitch Vila.
Yeah, hair under the arms over here. Fucking PBS bitch. Who can do certain things that a man can do? There are those special kind of things. But again, remember, Kathleen is autistic. Toops. What's up, Toops, man? Toops.
Hey, what's going on, Patrice?
Oh, hi, Pumpkin. How are you?
Pumpkin. I'm one of the few females that is actually going to be on your side because I don't understand why a woman would let a man dictate what. I'm a woman who can say, all right, maybe I know how to change the oil, but it's not my job. I'm a traditional wife. I will do the cooking. I will do the cleaning. Okay. I will wash your clothes. What's wrong with that? Society nowadays puts a hex on women who do that. They make them feel like second-class citizens. They make them feel like they're the weak, inferior species. And in my
well, it's not society, though. It's not society, too, fellow women.
Then what is it?
It's other women that make you.
Yeah, you're right. You're right.
Everybody.
Are you married?
Yes, I am married. Very happily married. And I'll tell you one thing. I see the difference between myself. I'm a stay-at-home mom. I'm a full-time student, but I do that on my own time. Where daddy can stay home with baby, but I don't like that you're trying to
upgrade yourself. I don't like the student thing.
The student.
That's the only thing I have a problem with. I want to keep
it. It's a part of my life. It is a part of my life.
All right, I don't like this uplifting your self-esteem shit, but go ahead.
No, it has nothing to do with self-esteem. It has to do with I do it on the side. My family comes first. My husband comes first. My child comes first. That is what I believe is my role as a woman. And I think...
Now, you know a lot of women are going to call you Auntie Tom or some shit. You know that, right?
Now, let me ask you something.
I'm going to make a lot of enemies with this call.
What is your husband willing to do for you because of the fact that you let him feel like a man?
You know what he's willing to do? He treats me like a woman.
Exactly.
And that's the difference I see. When I see these women who are so career-bound and who are so, they put their career first, and that's first, and that's, you know, their whole ego-driven, they are not treated with the respect that I am treated
with.
Keep going, baby. Keep going. Go ahead. Do your thing.
I'm telling you, this is how my philosophy is.
Wait a minute. Here's the one question I'm going to ask. I'm sorry to interrupt you.
Absolutely.
But here's the million-dollar question, bitch. What you look like?
I think I look pretty good. I'm on Pal Talk. You ask those guys what I look like.
Oh,
they love me.
Toops the 007 is sexy.
Absolutely.
Who's in there? Who's a Pal Talk motherfucker? Anybody know Toops 007?
They know me. They know who I am.
So you're hot.
Well, I mean,
guys think
decent.
You're hot.
I'd put it that way. But that's not the point.
It is a point, because if you was an ugly bitch, you better be a good fucking
you
have to bring it to the table, absolutely. I believe that you definitely have to bring... That's part of what I'm saying. You have to serve your husband.
Then why are you in school, if that's what you believe?
Because I believe in education is an important thing, and I like being educated. Whether I put it to use or not, I like being an educated person.
Ooh, Kathleen.
You know what I mean?
Of that, bitch, Vila?
I prefer to be an educated person. Whether I stay at home with my children or not, I'm still a human being. I'm still an individual, and I prefer to be educated. But my point is, my first priority is my family, and I don't know why that's so frowned upon.
Who is frowning upon anyone making a family?
Many people frown upon it.
I don't buy that.
Progressive women do. Progressive women do that.
Absolutely.
There's what you call legislation Nazis that, like, and black people do it too. Puerto Ricans do it too, where you get the quote unquote leaders of who you're supposed to be and how a certain group is supposed to act, and that's put into the forefront. And if you a nigga who likes to listen to Ozzy Osbourne, then it's like black people are gonna go, this sellout motherfucker.
Yeah.
Like, other people set the rules.
She isn't exceptional. The stay-at-home moms, there are a lot of them.
Yes.
There are a lot of them, but they're frowned upon.
Yes, but that's the same reason why, like, ABC, CBS, and NBC, they cater to the middle of the country, because that's who they think is the most important people. But most people ain't like those goofy motherfuckers. Right. And it's like...
And that's... Exactly.
Most
that's
women.
Exactly what I'm saying. Patrice, if I could just make one point. This is the point that I'm trying to make. Is that women who feel it is their job to take care of their husband and their family, they generally get looked down upon because they're not looking for their careers. They're not looking towards their own goals.
Do your friends...
And I think that's a selfish thing. It's my own personal opinion. I prefer to take care of my family first.
Wait a minute. Do your friends do this to you, or this is what you watch? Are your friends telling you that you're a fucking idiot?
No. My friends are absolutely admiring what I'm doing.
So your infrastructure, no one in your infrastructure tells you that you ain't shit.
Then why are you worried about it?
All right. Well, what's your question?
No, I'm not. No, but let me address the girl.
No, don't address her. No, don't address her. Listen, what was your question?
She had a question.
What was your question?
The reality is, though.
Hold on. Fuck the reality. Let me finish this bitch up. What's the question?
My question for you is, do you believe that a woman who knows her role actually holds a certain amount of power versus the woman who thinks she has the power because she's in the workplace and she's getting promotions and she's getting this and this,
Absolutely.
In my mind, has no power at
all?
Good
question. Thanks for the call. Great question. Thanks, Tubes. Thank you, baby.
No problem at all. You guys have an awesome night. Answer that question
for
me,
yes.
Please. Thank you.
Listen, here's the point. Here's the point to that. That, like I said before, a happy man means a happy woman. It trickles down from the man. A happy woman don't mean shit. She don't know how to be happy outside of how a man makes her feel. That's why she goes, make me feel like a queen, make me feel like this and that and the other
thing.
Make
me happy.
Make me happy, because she really don't know. But a woman who decides that she's going to make a conscious effort to make her man happy, because men need more desire to make women happy than women have to have desire to make us happy, because we're very easy. We're easier to deal with than you are. Meaning, if a motherfucker's sitting there sitting there playing Xbox 360, and you say, I'm not going to bother this motherfucker at all, I'm not going to, he could be on it for 8 hours, and I'm going to just exist in my own place for 8 hours until he wants to exist with me, that motherfucker right there, you just earned yourself 8 hours of happy. That motherfucker be like, sweetie, what do you need me to do? Because you left me alone for that 8 hours I want to be left alone. You were selling me what I wanted to buy. And at that particular time, I wanted to buy some fucking time not fucking with you. I wanted to buy some Xbox 360 time. And you gave it to me. So you know what? I'm going to figure out how to make you happy. I'm going to tune in to you. Instead of tuning out because you trying to force me to spend time with you, or force me to love you, or force me to talk to you, or whatever the fuck women do. Because you don't know how this chick, Toops, knows how to get what she wants. She goes to school, and I bet your fucking husband pays for the fucking bill because she's doing something.
Of course he does.
She's not forcing.
Working.
It's not attrition.
Yeah.
It's not attrition.
That's great. That's great if it's working for her. I don't see why she's so contentious. I mean, it's just...
Contentious? She didn't say she was contentious.
Most families need both incomes. Need the income of the mother and father.
And I'm quite sure if they needed a second income, she'd go to work.
That is great.
Her point
that's
is that beautiful. is that most, again, you might be exception to the rule. Again, generally, most women they look down. Most progressive, like one time this bitch, she was telling me, look, I said bitch a lot. I like saying bitch. Bitch to me is not no oppressive word to me. Just like nigga ain't. Motherfucking white boy call me nigga. I don't like, give a fuck about you.
Oh, you
nigga.
Don't care?
I don't give a fuck. Yeah. That nigga don't have no power. I call everybody nigga. I call my girl nigga. You understand? When I say bitch, it's a freedom to say that bitch, because you know what? Women have been able to ostracize that thing from our mouth. It's just a thing to let you know, baby, I'm a man. And if I call you a bitch, the only thing you really can do is get mad about it. You can't do shit else unless you go call the police. But other than that, if I go, shut up, bitch, and you go, don't call me no bitch, and I go, bitch, what's your next level? Your next level is to shut the fuck up or deal with it. That's why I say bitch. It's not because I go, hey, bitch, just to say it. I say it because, you know what, when I came up, I couldn't say it. I would be that guy to go, you're a bitch. And she would, not only her big brother would come, her mom would come, the teachers would come, and I'd be scared. You know why? Because in reality, I was really scared when I said it. I had no belief in the word when I said it. When I say bitch, I have pure belief in it. There's no place for a woman to take me if I say bitch. What you call me, all she could do is walk out, and I'm willing to take the L. I'm willing to take the loss just to be able to say bitch. Now, that may seem like a shitty battle, but it ain't when it comes down to it. Because when I tell my girl bitch, that's her way of knowing, like, if she's talking too much or she has, because she's not oppressed. But when I'm fucking talking to a man and she goes, she says, you know, I say, she's like doing too much talk. She's doing like that thing where your wife thinks she gets to know you. Like, once they figured you out.
Here you go again.
I done figured out your bullshit, motherfucker. Yeah, I know what you gonna say. I know what you know. As soon as they get like that, that she understands, all right, bitch, is that what it's like? You think you know now, right? You think you know how hot the sun is, motherfucker? You think you know how to put one foot in front of the other now? You think you know how to walk now without me, right? Okay, all right, bitch. And when she says, all right, bitch, she know that I ain't let her wrong yet. I ain't let the bitch wrong yet. So that's when I say certain things, man, there's a certain kind of way. It's not oppression. It's not this. But that's going back to progressive woman when she goes, how can I let my friends be seen with me? Is be seen with you, and you say, bitch, I'm a progressive black woman, don't you? I'm like, look, I don't give a fuck, bitch. I'm saying, look, when I say bitch, I'm saying all bitches. Bitches, you understand? I use it as a term of endearment. I use it as a exclamation point, a question. I can ready. Right. Here's the different inflections of bitch. Bitch, you know what that is? Shut up. What bitch? That's what did you just say? Bitch, you said some silly shit. Oh, bitch. That's no. That bitch is. That's all right. Here's some money. Oh, bitch, here. Or just bitches. It's a lot of different things, and I embrace saying it. I embrace saying it because you know what? It's empowering to me to be able to say it because you know what that does? It makes you ante up to let you know that I can choose to call you that or not call you that, but there's nothing really that you can do except for protest, except for get upset. If I say, bitch, you can't do nothing else but just be upset. That's it. I'm just letting you know what it is that I give you what I want to give you. You're not taking it, bitch. All right. We're going to go to Mr. Let me see. Who's gonna finish off? This is who the fuck? Wife? Who that divorce? Who the fuck? Let me go to Cliff, nigga. You been around? Cliff.
Hey, what's up, Patrice?
What's up? Why are you so mad, nigga? You been holding a while, huh?
Hey, man.
Go ahead.
Hey, listen. I got a question for you. I'm 27 years old. I'm dating a 45 year old, and I got a lot of my friends giving me shit for it. What do you think about the younger guys with the older women deal, man?
I don't know. Is it a fetish? You're not looking to marry or no shit like that, are you?
No.
Yeah,
no,
you just
no,
it's
Barry,
just a fuck. Yeah, that's good, man. Because when you unload on a motherfucker that's 27, when you get some 27 year old pussy, you're gonna be able to tear that shit up when you go back to your own age. So she's gonna teach you
a few
things.
That's
Mrs. Robinson right there. What's it smell like? What's 45 year old pussy smell like?
It smells like a little bit. Smells like the fish that's been in the market for about 2 or 3 days.
So it smells like she needs a little extra ice. It's the difference between a sushi bar in San Francisco and one downtown Jersey City.
Exactly.
Well, you know what, Kiki?
You're fucking
this old broad, man.
You're concerned with peer pressure. Fuck it. You know.
Yeah, and that's coming from a 47-year-old woman right there.
I'm 58. I'm 58.
Yeah, all right, man. Take care, Cliff. Keep fucking her. Tear up.
All right. Peace out.
And pluck out some of that gray pussy ass you got. I know it's awful down there. Go to Mr. Go to Anthony in Vegas, man. Anthony?
Yo.
Hi.
Mike Philly.
Anthony in Vegas. Says.
That's me.
Okay.
You got me?
Yeah, go ahead, man.
Black Philly, how you doing?
Oh, Black Philly.
That's you.
No,
Black,
this is Anthony.
Oh,
that's
Black
you.
Philly.
Yeah.
Oh, Philly.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, okay, thank you. That's a new nickname. Oh, thank you very much, Black Philly.
Kathleen. I love to hear Kathleen swear. It's really sexy.
Oh, thank you.
Swear for the
man.
Thank you, motherfucker.
I want to ask you.
There go another rape. Maybe he won't kill
you. Is she a cougar?
Huh?
Is she a cougar?
You
can say that.
Kathleen is...
I'm very stalkable.
It's a lot of ish. You know what? There's a lot of ish in her. Like, she's hottish. She's smartish.
When she comes.
It's probably weird. She probably
sexy.
You know, it probably sounds like a fly dying. It sounds like a Cessna crashing. So what's
Patrice,
up? What's going on?
I want to know. I'm sure you're aware of the old unwritten law that you never fuck a girl. You never make a girlfriend out of a girl you fuck on the first date. I wanted to know your opinion on that.
That's young guy shit.
Exactly.
That's
again, young. How old are you? How old are you?
I'm 35. I'm 35.
You're supposed to encourage the whoreness in every
young
bitch.
Yeah, seriously, dude.
Encourage the whoreness.
It's a young man's thing. When you're in high school, like this thing, like remember when you was high school? And like when I was high school, somebody said to me, was she good in bed? My answer would be, she gave me pussy. Well, I don't understand what that means. When you get 35, you know what that means. Like, a good fuck is a tangible reference. But, like, now, it's like when a girl gives me pussy now, I'm mature enough to deal with getting pussy early. I wasn't mature enough to be getting pussy when I was 18 on the first date. But now, if a bitch gives me pussy now, I like her more. Yeah. A lot of people don't understand the reason a lot of times men don't like women is because what you put us through for pussy. Like, the fact is that you could fuck me now, but you're not just because of, like you said, the unwritten rule of not fucking on the first date. And all you gotta do is say, why? I'm gonna tell you something. That's the best question to ask a bitch. It's like, if you go, listen, let's sleep together. I don't even know you. First of all, if a chick says she don't know me before we fuck, you don't know me any better if we talk for a year. My dick didn't change, bitch. What you think, you know my dick better? Fuck me now. Introduce yourself to my dick, too. Hi, pussy. How are you? Nice to meet you. I'm Patrice. Let me shake your fucking
labia.
Uterus. Yeah, nigga, fuck that, man. That shit is fucking on the first date, dude. Look, like I said, my girl's a hoe, and I say that with love, man. I love my girl.
You fucking on the first date?
I would if I could have, but let me tell you how she got dick from me. Here's what a loser she is. Here's how she got some dick from me. I made a conscious decision to be her friend. I said, look, I'm going to be this bitch's friend. But
that's what I'm talking about. What if you want to, like, you know, be a friend first and then, you know.
I'd say that's the way to go.
Go ahead. What did you say?
Yeah, I think that's the way to go.
To be friends?
Yeah, and then fuck them.
Why?
Kathleen, you want to be my friend?
What if he's... this nigga's trying to get Kathleen. You sneaky motherfucker. Hang up on him. See you later, man.
I like you. Thank you, cocksucker.
Cocksucker.
Number three.
Motherfucker.
Phil. Okay, Phil in New Jersey, man. What's up?
Yeah, what's up, Patrice?
How you doing, man?
All right, man. All right. Me and my wife separated, like, a year ago.
Mm-hmm.
And, in the whole process of things, like, you know, she got messed up in the whole party scene doing drugs and shit. And I'm with my kids.
Okay.
So, it's been like a year. After like a year, she says she wants to... She's better now. She wants to become a family again and all.
Wait, how'd you lose your kids? What the fuck? You lost your kids?
She took them.
No, I didn't lose them. I got them.
You got the kids. Okay.
She's partying,
yeah,
right?
Okay. Yeah, I got the kids.
Okay.
But then she said, you know, she wanted to get back together again. She wanted to be a family. She wanted to work things out.
Right.
So I started talking to her for a couple weeks, and then next thing you know, she goes, well, don't think you're exclusive or anything. I'm still seeing, like, three other people.
Oh.
Fuck that bitch.
What the fuck? You know what she... Let me tell you exactly what the fuck she doing to you, dude. You... It's like... again, we boil it down to the basic thing. It's like a girl that you love. She's abusing your love, nigga. You can't let her abuse your fucking love. She knows that no matter what happens, she can always come back to good old sweet Phil. I understand that you're always going to take her back, that you always going to go, you know, all right. So what she's doing is you are her stability, nigga. You are her blanket. You are her mattress. You are everything she needs to be comfy so she can be out in her world of horse shit. You ever see that movie when Meg Ryan was a drunk bitch Andy Garcia.
Right.
Just kept, that's you, nigga. Fuck that bitch. And that's what you gotta tell. Fuck her. You done it enough. You did your job, nigga. Take those kids. Find you a good woman, man, and stop letting this bitch abuse you. Cause her lifestyle is more important than you. It's more important than the kids. It's more important than her, nigga. She don't even care about herself. Let that bitch die without you, nigga. Stop. She's a weight. She's hanging you down.
And make sure you have legal custody of the kids, or look into that before anything happens.
Bye, Phil. Like,
you know, whatever.
All right, bye, fucking. And make sure that you feed them oatmeal. And you crazy bitch.
Well, the woman will get the custody, and he doesn't want. He loves these kids.
Nigga,
he already got the kids.
He got the kids.
She's got a
drug problem. Did you hear what he said?
Yes, I know. But not if she leaves. She can get them easily. She might just
get
come
the fuck
back
out of here. She's a junkie. But
I know she is.
No, the mother. Not
definitely.
He already got them.
She can't come back from drugs
and then say I'm not on drugs. I want my fucking kid.
How do you know? It happens all the time.
Nigga, I swear, Kathleen.
Call number
7. Brian, what's up, man?
Hey, what's up, Patrice? How you doing, man?
How you doing, dude?
Yeah, I'm doing all right. I know you're going to wrap up the show. I wanted to give you your heavy props, man. Not only are you dead on, but you make it very interesting with the funny shit that you're saying. So I appreciate you being on not only Opie and Anthony, but your own show. But I want to tell all these guys out there that are pussies, they let their women run their lives, a bunch of punks, to just listen to what you have to say. Because I used to be like them. And about maybe 7-8 years ago, I used to be like them. You know, with the flowers and yes, dear, and all this horse shit. And once I started to throw down the gauntlet, people, bitches be crying, oh, I want you back, and I want to be with you. And believe me, man, I have black chicks, Asian chicks, Spanish chicks, and I'm not anything special to look at, bro. I'm not anything special. I'm an average-looking guy.
But I tell these motherfuckers,
fuck you, I ain't calling. You pay for your own shit, let some other douchebag.
Give him a pimp card.
Yeah, nigga. Leave your address, you're going to get a pimp card in the mail, motherfucker.
Pimp card in the mail.
Yeah, Brian. Yeah, nigga.
Patrice, this is for everybody else. Listen to Patrice. Believe me, if you follow Patrice's shit, you will get where you want to be, motherfuckers.
You hear that, Kathleen, nigga? Thanks, Brian. Good looking out, man.
Thank you, Brian.
Our work is done.
Let me try to stroke my ego some more. Go to Payday in Philly. Payday.
Yo.
This nigga is
crazy.
He's high.
Hang up.
Nice high energy caller.
Count your drugs, nigga.
Right.
This nigga's counting drugs. This nigga's doing scenes from Scarface on the fucking phone. Hey, Scott in South Carolina. What's up, man? Scott.
Hey, Patrice. What's up, sweetie?
What's up, Scott?
Hey, by the way, we just got back from seeing little Jimmy in Atlanta. By the way, he fucking killed. Amazing.
Yeah.
That's good. Did he melt under the hot lights? Because that's what fucking scallops do.
He was beautiful. I wanted to lick the fucking sweat off his fucking forehead.
Really? Did he look like the inside of somebody's stomach? He looks like somebody turned inside out.
It doesn't fucking matter.
Oh, that's good, man. What's up, dude?
Yeah, well, you were talking earlier about our bitches making us happy. You know what would make me happy? I would absolutely love. I've never done it before. I want to have some fucking anal sex.
Whoa! You want to stick somebody, or you want somebody to stick you?
No. I don't want to get in that gay shit. I would like to stick it in my wife, and she is such a fucking prude, and I cannot.
It's very easy to do that. You do assy shit when you're eating a pussy. You stick the tip of your finger in there. When you're eating, you lick her asshole.
Lick
you just do assy stuff. That's it.
Rub the thumb. Spit on the thumb.
Bite the thumb. Bite the inside of the lower cheek.
The lower ass cheek.
I'm sorry. Do you have any ways a guy can fuck you in the ass, Kathleen?
No, I'm not into it.
Hey, man, Scott, thanks for calling, man. Listen, everybody. Dan, go ahead. Dan, what's up? Dan? I love you, Dan. Nice talking to you.
All right.
Listen, everybody, sorry we didn't get to you. We try to get to as many calls as possible here.
Welcome to the
Black Phillip Show. But you know we like to talk. We got this big mouth bitch, Kathleen, but we love her. Yeah. And listen, you can write Get Rid of the Hole again, but we can't. You know what I mean?
Keep her around.
Because she's just a crazy, retarded bitch. She has nothing to plug, anything you want to plug?
Yes, I do.
Get out of here.
I am in a movie with Joe Rogan called, ironically, A Man's World.
Yeah.
You, in order to see it, go on cinequest.org or kellykirsten.com, and you could get a copy of it.
What
or
is
whatever.
It again? Say it again.
It's called A Man's World.
And you got to do what to see it?
Oh, and Joe Rogan plays my battery.
No, give
boyfriend.
Heidi to see it again.
Cinequest.org.
How do you spell that? How do you spell that?
CINEQUEST.org.
Okay, dot cinequest.org to
or
see.
Or Kelly Kirsten, KellyKirsten.com.
And to go see this horseshit independent movie.
Yeah.
You, Dante, anything?
I'll be at the Comedy Village next weekend.
All right, nigga. Well, thank you for joining us with the Black Phillip Show. And I like to thank Fan. I like to thank Danny. I like to thank Half Black Sammy and fucking, who's that, Travis or whatever. I like to thank everybody. And, of course, our benefactor, Mr. Opie, for having us. And I appreciate it. Y'all take care, man. Thanks for joining us.